Guys, I'm Basil here. Today, we'll take a walk through Elwynn Forest. Statues of Alliance heroes at the moment. I do not recall their names, but I believe these two exactly the same guys we're looking at now, which was Alaria and Duralion, venerated Alliance heroes who participated in a crusade against the Burning Legion. But today we will focus on Elwynn Forest itself. And history. Now we'll take a road that's gonna lead us to Northshire. Starting zone for new players that choose to play as human. Oh, hello there. One of the Stormwind guards. Except that night, you will be starting your journey in Northshire. It's just a short walk from here, so take a shortcut. Just need to be careful in this area, as it's occupied by the fires some safe. But otherwise, we would be attacked on sight. Seen in Ironforge and Darnassus. It's pretty unmistakable. Every time you're in a human settlement, it just by looking at the buildings. This road gonna lead us to Goldshire. It's not far from here. You can actually see the buildings from here. Goldshire is pretty special place, especially for every Alliance player. Some players running around. us. You can buy your supplies here before going further south. Also, there is a forge just on the other side of the road. Pretty popular place. If you want to get your first decent armor or weapons. Its location, Goldshire, is usually a first stop for all new human players. This is a Darkmoon Fair. Setting up shop once in a while. You can see some jugglers, fire breather. They are down here, I believe, once a week. And you can take that portal to teleport instantly. Eastvale logging camp. So, while we're walking, there are some facts about the Elwyn Forest. As you can see, is a vast woodland of stately hardwoods nestled just below the foothills of the Burning Steps. The west are the dry prairie fields of Westfall. The idyllic Redridge Mountains lie to the east, and to the south, Landing is where Dustwood is located. Elwyn Forest is the heartland of the human kingdom of Stormwind. Consequently, as it was said, it is the starting point of nearly all human characters. It's a gorgeous span of fertile land and thick forests. Sunny and cheerful during the day, and silent and peaceful at night. It's home to many farmers, loggers, miners. It's a tranquil region. Several friendly places to stop. Little troubles this region. Kobolds infiltrate some mines, such as Fargo Deep Mine, or just below the Morlocks also. Some lakes and rivers, but overall, Elwynn Forest is a pretty safe place. The building you can see ahead of us is called Sora. Before Cataclysm, it was a place, the only place in Kingdom of Stormwind where warlocks could safely gather and train. They were not actually welcomed within the walls of the Stormwind City. Now, these days, Tower of Azora is occupied by mages. See some gnomes, gnomish assistants, I believe. There are two or three mages, actual mages, that reside here in the tower. Labyrinth of stairs and bridges inside. Lots of books. It's a place of study. Also, I believe some guilds this place as the headquarters. We are at the top of a tower right now. There are some artifacts, so a lot of magic items. This one looks like some scrying orb or something similar. Lots of assistants walking around. Busy place. was saying before. Elwyn Forest overall is a pretty safe place. There are a lot of places like this. Lots of villages where you can stop and rest. Roads are patrolled by guards. You can even meet an occasional traveling merchant. But the one should stick to the roads while in Elwyn Forest, as the forest itself is home to many fearsome and territorial creatures, such as bears. Themselves are not in any real danger, but if you are really low level or inexperienced, you may not be so lucky. And wolves, especially when in a pack, they can easily overwhelm you. Anyway, if we look around, you can notice that Elwyn Forest enjoys consistently good weather. It's warm, humid, it's very few stormy days. This woodland, while completely different than woods of Teldrassil we could see before, it's still pleasant and tranquil. You can meet some loggers, fishers, as logging and fishing is basis of local economy. Lots of guards and militia that keeps people safe from kobolds and warlocks. Actually, there is some wanted poster, probably some quest here. Eastvale logging camp, just next to it on the other side of the road, there is a bandit den. Because Elwyn Forest is also a headquarters Brotherhood, a group these days. It changed us. There are lots of riding trainers, especially around Stormwind, and us human player, you're no longer restricted to human specific mounts as you were before. Eastern border of Elven Forest. This tower marks the end of the area behind this outpost. Lies zone, which is called Red Ridge Mountains. We won't be going there today. Just have a quick look. Western border. Where actually Elven Forest meets Westfall. Right now, just behind trees ahead, there is another area called Duskwood. There is just a small bridge spanning that river, and usually this is second area where new players go. As there are lots of quests, I like Duskwood myself, even though it's a little bit depressive. See some warlocks mentioned before. We'll go around them. We don't want to be involved in a fight with them. So while we're going to the border with Westfall, history of this region, actually the history of Elwyn Forest and humanity as well, because the humans have lived in Elwyn Forest for centuries. Members of all alliance races can be frequently seen traveling and residing in Elwyn Forest due to its proximity to the capital city of Stormwind. This region organizes its festivals and celebrations around the planting calendar, as you can find some fertile farmlands within Elwyn Forest. Elwyn is also visited periodically by traveling Darkmoon Fair. We could see that a while before as well. Criminals caught in the area, such as defiers, bandits, are usually sent to Stormwind, and punished in stockades, which is also a dungeon. It's basically holding area for all criminals, drunks, pickpockets. Some of them stay there for really long. Anyways, very little is known of Elwyn Forest history before Stormwind City was founded by Arathi bloodline. Ever since humans first settled forest, it has thrived under their stewardship. However, Elwyn Forest was captured once by the Horde during their bloody campaign to Stormwind in the First War. The resources city at the end of the Second War. They regained Elwyn Forests as well. It costs the Kingdom of Stormwind a significant amount of gold and resources to rebuild broken land. As a result, the kingdom's economy has flagged since it was rebuilt. Many dissidents defected service of the kingdom, and they formed the Defiers Brotherhood. The Brotherhood reaches into Elwyn Forest from time to time, preying on some lone travelers. See them occasionally here and there, but the main center of operations lies somewhere in Westfall. Some say the Defiers Brotherhood have some case against Stormwind, because they were formed by dissidents, the middle and lower classes of citizens, Stormwind citizens, that became fed up with high taxes and unpaid labor during their service to the kingdom. But others saying that these people are just whiners who charged too much in the first place for their work. Anyway, against the all odds, bandits and other problems, Stormwind managed to return Elwyn to much of its former majesty and glory. Northshire was rebuilt and has become a recruiting center for Stormwind that also Goldshire, and its famous Lion's Pride Inn, the one we've seen before, have returned to their former glory as a bustling hub of activity. Today, the only reminders of the Horde's occupation are few, scattered and abandoned orcish machines of war, some catapults broken and rotting, though the majority of Elwyn remained untouched during the cataclysm. The Northshire wasn't as lucky. The Defiers Brotherhood, which was already weakened and nearly broken by Stormwind military, they also have been all killed, and the area are burned down by Blackrock orcs. These orcs Slayer, and as we could have seen before, orcs under his leadership are becoming bigger and bigger threat. Even though there are some dangers within the Elwyn Forest, it's still a beautiful place to visit and to walk around. This forest is a labyrinth. It's a labyrinthine mixture of rushing rivers, lakes, gold mines, beautiful, magnificent trees, lush glades. Some pieces of rich farmland. Elwyn Forest is a really big place, especially for new players that are kind of forced to traverse it on foot before they are able to get their first mount. So it's nearly impossible to visit it and see all of it in one go. So unfortunately, this will be the end journey for today. lustful. So, as always,